We request our Honorable Director General BSF, Shri K. K. Sharma, to kindly present with a sapling of Tulsi. This sapling symbolizes hope, new direction towards a promising, healthy, wonderful future for all of us. Thank you so much, sir. And we take this opportunity to invite our Honorable Director General BSF, Shri K. K. Sharma, for the welcome address.
Adarniya Guruji, उपस्थित अतिथिग्रहण प्रहरी परिवार के सदस्य देवियों एवं सज्जनों, आज रुस्तमजी स्मृति व्याख्यान रुस्तमजी मेमोरियल लेक्चर के अवसर पर पद्मश्री डॉक्टर एचआर नागेंद्र जी की उपस्थिति से मैं सीमा सुरक्षा बल के प्रमुख के तौर पर और व्यक्तिगत तौर पर अत्यंत गौरवान्वित महसूस कर रहा हूँ। गुरुजी ने हमारा आमंत्रण स्वीकार किया और हमारे बीच पधारे। मैं प्रहरी परिवार की ओर से आपका हृदय से धन्यवाद करता हूं। गुरुजी योगा और लीडरशिप पर व्याख्यान देंगे, ये हमारा सौभाग्य है कि हम आपके स्वाध्याय परीक्षण एवं अनुभव पर आधारित शब्दों को सुनेंगे और आत्मसात करेंगे। गुरुजी इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ साइंस बेंगलोर के एलुमनाई हैं और गुरुजी की डॉक्टरेट मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग के विषय पर है। गुरुजी की महारत एरोस्पेस स्पेस के फील्ड में रही है और इन्होंने नासा के प्रोजेक्ट में योगदान दिया है। अपने नासा असाइनमेंट्स के बाद गुरुजी थुम्बा स्पेस सेंटर तिरुवनंतपुरम के दौरे पर जाते रहते थे। इन्हीं दौरों के बीच गुरुजी के रॉक मेमोरियल कन्याकुमारी की यात्रा इनके आज के गुरु स्वरूप योगमय व्यक्तित्व की आधारशिला बनी। स्वामी विवेकानंद योग अनुसंधान संस्थान सूक्ष्म में एस व्यासा की संस्थापना एवं योग के द्वारा आमजन को प्राचीन आरोग्य विधि उपलब्ध कराने के लिए गुरुजी को विश्व स्तरीय मान्यता दी गई है। गुरुजी के योगा थेरेपी ने स्वास्थ्य के क्षेत्र में नए आयाम जोड़े हैं। गुरुजी ने अपनी बहन डॉक्टर नागरत्ना, जो कि मेडिकल प्रोफेशन से हैं, के साथ लगभग 500 शोध पत्र प्रस्तुत किए हैं। इन शोध पत्रों में योग विधि द्वारा नॉन कम्युनिकेबल डिजीजेस का निदान एवं उपचार का ज्ञान बांटा गया है। देश विदेश के कई मेडिकल इंस्टीट्यूट इन प्रबंधों से जुड़े हैं। आप मैन मेकिंग और नेशन बिल्डिंग के उद्देश्य से योग विद्या को आमजन तक पहुँचाने के लिए प्रतिबद्ध हैं। सीमा सुरक्षा बल ने भी योग को दैनिक जीवन में अपनाया है। बीएसएफ सर्वोत्तम योग प्रशिक्षक एस व्यासा से ही प्रशिक्षित है। योग के समुचित इस्तेमाल से हम अपने राष्ट्र रक्षा और राष्ट्र निर्माण, इन दोनों ही कर्तव्यों का व्यवस्थित पालन कर रहे हैं। गुरुजी, आज हम सब आपके सुझावों को अपनाकर अपने नेतृत्व गुणों को और भी परिष्कृत करने के लिए इस सभागार में उपस्थित हुए हैं। मैं आपका पुनः स्वागत करते हुए व्याख्यान शुरू करने का अनुरोध करता हूं। नमस्कार, जय हिंद।
बधाई है शर्मा जी फॉर वंडरफुल ग्रेट परफेक्ट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन दैट आई सीन हियर एंड योर टीम हैज डन सच ए फैंटास्टिक वर्क। एवरी मिनट आई वॉज नोटिंग डाउन, मिनट टू मिनट जो दिए थे उसी के अनुसार चला। कितना सुंदर है, बहुत आनंद आया। माय डियर ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, इट्स ए ग्रेट अपॉर्चुनिटी दैट शर्मा जी एंड हिज टीम ऑफ द बीएसएफ ग्रुप हैज गिवन अस टू शेयर विथ यू द डायमेंशंस ऑफ योगा एंड एज पॉस्टुलेटेड बाय स्वामी विवेकानंद, ए ग्रेट सीयर। As you know, in a single speech in the Parliament of Religions in Chicago, he brought India to the forefront. Sirf do shabd usne bola, brothers and sisters of America. Sab log itna acha usko laga ki kartadan se 5 minute ke liye uska swagat kiya. Usne kya bataya udhar? So Swamiji ne bataya ki yog ka mool lakshya kya hai. Usko batate hue, देखिए आज क्या हो रहा है कि रिलीजन के नाम पर हम लड़ाई कर रहे हैं। परंतु सही लक्ष्य क्या है रिलीजन का? प्रेम, सौहार्दता, शांति को बढ़ाने का। परंतु क्या हुआ है, वे वे द लार्जेस्ट नंबर ऑफ वॉर्स इन द नेम ऑफ रिलीजन, मैसेकर्ड मिलियंस एंड फ्लोन रिवर्स ऑफ ब्लड। सो लेट दिस पार्लियामेंट ऑफ रिलीजन स्टॉप दिस एंड सी दैट वी प्रमोट हार्मनी, लव, पीस, अफेक्शन, फ्रेंडशिप अमंग द पीपल। दैट वाज द गोल, दैट्स व्हाट योगा वांट्स। योगा ब्रिंग्स पीस, हार्मनी, लव, अफेक्शन एंड ब्रिंग गुड हेल्थ। सर, हम विश्वेश्वर आप सब लोग जानते हैं, महान लीडर था, इंजीनियर में इसका बहुत महान देन है विश्व के लिए। उसने एक बार बेंगलोर से मैसूर जा रहा था, ट्रेन में आराम से बैठे थे और आधा घंटे में मैसूर पहुंचने वाले थे, और एकदम उसने उधर से उठ गया और इधर उधर देखना शुरू किया, खिड़की के पास गया, अपने वॉच को देखा, वापस आकर चेन को पुल कर दिया, पुल द चेन, ट्रेन केम टू ए हॉल्ट। द ड्राइवर एंड द गार्ड दे केम, दे लोकेटेड द कंपार्टमेंट, एंटर्ड इन, हु इज द पर्सन हु पुल द चेन, दे वर वेरी एंग्री, यू नो, देन कॉमली हियर हियर आई एम, क्या बात है, चेन को क्यों पुल किया, क्या बात है, यू नो, प्लीज गो 300 यार्ड्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ योर इंजिन एंड सी व्हाट हैज हैपेंड टू योर रेल। बताया, हाँ मैं ड्राइवर हूं, क्या हुआ, कुछ नहीं है, ऐसा पागलपन का बात नहीं करो। द गार्ड सेज, नाउ डोंट एक्ट दिस फूलिश थिंग्स, यू हैव टू पे ए फाइन ऑफ 250 रुपीज। उस समय 250 रुपीज बहुत बड़ा था। तो उसके बाजू में जो था उसने बताया, ए किसको बोल रहे हैं, ये सामान माने वह क्या, देखो उसको, वो हमारा ग्रेट सरम है। ओ सॉरी सर, सॉरी सर। दोनों जाकर वो टार्च लाइट लगाते हुए आगे चले और एग्जैक्टली 300 गज में वो जो रेल था वो टूट गया था। यदि ट्रेन उधर गया तो पूरा से पूरे निकल आते थे, ह्यूज डेप्थ अबाउट 200 फीट, ऑल थाउजेंड्स ऑफ पीपल वुड हैव डाइड, इट प्रिवेंटेड अ ग्रेट एक्सीडेंट। ये कैसा हुआ, ये मैजिक है क्या, इसको मैं बोलता हूँ डेप्थ ऑफ परसेप्शन। तो जब उसने आराम से बैठे थे कुर्सी में, तो उस समय ही वॉज हियरिंग, ईयर्स वर देयर एंड द रिदमिसिटी ऑफ द ट्रेन वॉज गोइंग ऑन, बट एन इट रीच दैट प्लेस the rhythmicity of the train was broken, it was going on jug 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 ho raha tha na, wo ekdam wo toot gaya, jug 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 aisa hona shuru ho gaya. Here ears were so sharp, immediately he found there's something wrong. Then he thought what could be wrong, then rail must have broken, isliye there's the breaking of the rhythm. Then he went to the window, looked at the clock, what the speed with which is going, and he calculated what distance the rail would have broken. What a mathematical genius! Even today, I don't understand how he was able to calculate. 300 gaj, and then it was broken. This is what I call depth of perception. His ears were so strong, his mathematical genius. He is a leader. So every professional develops an eye in their profession. तो लीडर के लिए ऐसा ही एक परसेप्शन होना चाहिए, ऑल हिज सेंसेस आर हाईली डेवलप्ड, हिज माइंड इज हाईली डेवलप्ड, वेरी शार्प, वेरी इंटेलिजेंट, वेरी ब्रिलियंट, वेरी क्रिएटिव, वेरी इनोवेटिव। टेक द वर्ड योगा, कमिंग फ्रॉम द संस्कृत वर्ड योगा, युज्यते अनेन इति योगः, योगा इज टू जॉइन, योगा इज टू कंबाइन। व्हाट यू आर गोइंग टू कंबाइन, small little personality we are going to expand and to become great human beings, super human beings, divine human beings, reach the highest levels of perfection. That is what yoga means. So it raises ourselves from our animal level to become normal human beings, great human beings, featured by giving and sharing and sharing. More and more give to the society than what we receive. and we divine human beings and reach. This is what yoga means. So it is a process of acceleration of one's growth, said Swami Vivekananda. How to do that? The great Maharishi Patanjali has given the technique. He said, yoga is to gain mastery over the mind. He said, yogaha chitta vritti nirodaha. To gain mastery over the mind. It consists of two dimensions. One, before the Britishers came, we all had the Gurukul system of education, in which every student was to sit quietly, calmly, do meditation, go into depth, apart from their development of this thing. So when the Britishers came, they said, sitting quiet, calm, silent is laziness. They said, don't be lazy, come on, get up and be brilliant, sharp, working. Jaldi kaam karna hai, achha kaam karna hai, aisa baito mat, aur alasi bano mat, thamas hai hai, karo. They had conceived of only two states of the mind. A brilliant mind, a sharp mind, an energetic mind, dynamic mind, faster mind. Another is a lazy mind, silent mind, tranquil mind, calm mind, and lazy and lethargic mind. They had conceived of only two things. That's how the entire education system was revamped in our country. All over the world, they did this thing. The whole of education system in developing of the mind has become only twofold. For the first time in history, probably in 1970s, our Maharishi Mahesh Yogi brought to the forefront saying, no, there is a third state of the mind. And that state of mind is a calm mind, tranquil mind, peaceful mind, and silent mind, which is not laziness. It is not drowsiness. It is not sleepiness. It is not tamasic mind. It is not inefficient mind. Highly efficient mind. Better than the efficiency that you get in a faster mind. This is what he brought out. So this is what yoga defines. Mind control. Mana prashamana upayaha yogaha. It is a yoga is to calm down the mind, tranquil the mind, tire the mind. So we are trying to fly only with one wing. The second wing has gone. So we have to revamp the entire education system based on this fundamental dimension of yoga. Do cheez hona chahiye, man ko shant karne ka upay bahut jaruri hai. Ye jab tak nahi karenge aapko bahut asantulan hai. ये असंतुलन ही मूल कारण है आजकल के नए सब बीमारियों का. आजकल के आस्थमा, डायबिटीज, हाइपरटेंशन, हार्ट प्रॉब्लम, एपिलेप्सी, माइग्रेन, इरिटेबल बाउल सिंड्रोम, कैंसर, सबका जड़ है इधर. इसको आधी बोलते हैं. तो ये आधी से बनता है व्याधि. इसको आधी जब व्याधि बोलते हैं एनसीडी के लिए. तो इसके लिए क्या करना, पतंजलि ने बताया, ये मन के स्तर पर हम उसको पूरा हम पक्का करना, समत्व में लाना, दोनों चीजों को हम डेवलप करना, यह बहुत जरूरी है. भगवद गीता में बताया जाता है कि देखो, कर्म करना अच्छा है, एक्शन करना बहुत ठीक है, अच्छा काम करना है, ट्रांसपेरेंट काम करना है, इंटीग्रिटी काम करना अच्छा है, परंतु उसके साथ साथ अकर्म को भी हम जोड़ना है. कर्म और अकर्म दोनों जीवन का अंग है. कर्मणोहि बोद्धव्यम बोद्धव्यं च विकर्मणः अकर्मणश्च बोद्धव्यम गहना कर्मणो गति ही, बताया जाता है. क्या मतलब, अच्छा काम है बुरा काम है दोनों ठीक है, उसको समझ, सब लोग जानते हैं हम. फिर क्यों बुरे काम में फंस जाते हैं, क्योंकि हमारे मन के ऊपर नियंत्रण नहीं है. तीसरा अंश है ये अकर्म, जो कर्म नहीं करना, शांत रहना, चुप रहना और मन प्रशमन करके रहना है, ये बहुत जरूरी है. यदि आप इसको नहीं करेंगे तो फंस जाते हैं अलग अलग बीमारियों से. तो कर्म से क्या होता है, तनाव जगता है, और उसको कम करने के लिए, रिलैक्सेशन करने के लिए अकर्म का जरूरत है. इसलिए हम रोज सोते हैं और यह है अकर्म, उसमें चिंतन नहीं होता है. परंतु यदि आपको सोना नहीं होता है, डिस्टर्ब स्लीप है, दूसरे दिन ना कितना खराब लगता है ना. यदि अच्छा नींद हो गया, बहुत अच्छा रहता है, फ्रेश होता है, एफिशिएंट है, सब कुछ होता है. यदि ये नहीं करेंगे, डिस्टर्ब स्लीप हो गया, कितना खराब हो जाता है. सो गिविंग रेस्ट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो टू स्टे इन अकर्मा इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट. तो भगवद गीता योग में बताया जाता है, यू रेस्ट टू द सिस्टम. इमेजिन यू डेवलप 100 यूनिट्स ऑफ स्ट्रेस, during your day. All the 100 units you should be able to remove. Supposing you remove only 60 units of stress, remaining 40 is going to accumulate, is going to hit you. Kuch saal mein diabetes ho gaya, hypertension ho gaya, heart problem ho gaya, ek din stroke ho gaya, ek din heart trouble ho gaya. Achhe kaam kar rahe hain, pure aapke desh ke liye kaam kar rahe hain, aur bahut sakriya hai, aur man bahut tej hai, aapko bahut sharp hai, intelligent hai, innovative hai, creative hai. Parantu ye rest nahi denge, जरूर तकलीफ हो जाएगा. बहुत लोगों को देखता हूं मैं, पूरा समर्पित जीवन है उनका, फिर भी उसको स्ट्रोक हो गया, हार्ट अटैक हो गया और डायबिटीज में फंस गए. क्यों? इसका कारण है, कृष्ण भगवान यही बोलता है. इसलिए हमको अकर्म को डेवलप करना है, वो जो तनाव जगते हैं पूरा पूरा उसको निकालना है, यही योग बोलते हैं. एक छोटा कीजिए, अभ्यास कीजिए. आप राइट हैंड को लीजिए पाँव को और हार्ट के ऊपर रखिए, राइट हैंड, कीप इट ऑन द हार्ट, फील द हार्ट, क्लोज योर आईज एंड फील द हार्ट, हार्ट बीट. ऑल ऑफ यू कैन फील द हार्ट बीट, नो? एनीबडी कुड नॉट फील द हार्ट बीट? कोई इसको महसूस नहीं कर पा रहे हैं? नो हार्ट, आपको हार्ट बीट है. हार्ट बीट को महसूस नहीं हो रहा है क्योंकि सेंसिटिविटी नहीं है. इसलिए वो सेंसिटिविटी करते जाएंगे तो मिल जाएगा. इसी ढंग से पल्स है, पल्स को इधर रखिए, उसको देखिए, पल्स फील हो रहा है, पल्स ज़्यादा हो रहा है, कम हो रहा है कभी कभी, और इसको इधर रखेंगे, पल्स और हार्ट बीट दोनों को महसूस करना. फाइंड आउट द कनेक्शन बिटवीन द टू, देन योर सेंसिटिविटी इज हाई. इस ढंग से अपने सेंसिटिविटी को बढ़ाना है. उसके बाद रेस्पिरेटरी चेंजेस, सांस कभी कभी ज़्यादा हो जाता है, कम हो जाता है. कैन यू फील दैट चेंजेस इन व्हेन यू आर एक्सरसाइजिंग, व्हेन यू आर डूइंग आसना, व्हेन यू आर डूइंग वॉकिंग, डूइंग एनीथिंग, द ब्रीदिंग गोस ऑन चेंजिंग. कभी कभी रेस्पिरेटरी चेंजेस बिकम्स वेरी शैलो, वेरी फास्ट ब्रीदिंग. व्हाट्स आवर नॉर्मल ब्रीदिंग रेट? 15 to 18 पर मिनट. जस्ट चेक. सम पीपल हु आर हाईली स्ट्रेस्ड अप, एंग्शियस, the breathing rate is very high. We made a small research. We took 1000 cases of bronchial asthma. The breathing rate was 23.6. 1000 cases of hypertension, 25.8. 1000 cases of anxiety neurosis, it was 29.6. Higher the anxiety, higher the tension, higher the stress, faster the breathing rate. It becomes shallow. Isliye kya karna? Kam karna breathing rate. Bring it down to normal, 15 to 18. और इसके बाद उसको कम करना, यह है प्राणायाम है. तो उसके लिए योगा क्लास में आना शुरू किया. उसमें डीप रिलैक्सेशन होता है, आर्टिक्यूआरटी डीआरटी, उसको साइक्लिक मेडिटेशन बोलते हैं, और आराम से वो कर रहे थे शवासन में. देन इन द फाइनल डीआरटी आई सेड, इमेजिन अ वॉश इन फाइनल ब्लू स्काई एंड अ वंडरफुल राइजिंग मून, सो नाइस, सो नाइस. And at the end of that, I asked them, were you able to imagine? No, sir, it was all blank, you know. Then I told, okay, how much big is the blank? Something like this side. Can you make it very big? Can you make it very small? The blank, the dark thing? I will try, sir. In 1 week, they will have to expand it, bring it then. Then I told, can you change the color to black, to dark brown? I will try. They tried. Within 3 days they were able to do. One by one different colors. 15 days. Then I told, can you make this thing as a nice circle? Can you make it as a rectangle? Can you make it as a cube? Can you make it as a sphere? They took 1 month. At the end of that, they were able to do that. They were very happy that a lot of things are happening. Then I again called them to that garden. Oh, Edward Rose. Is par isko dekho. देख रहे थे. Close your eyes and see. Got it, sir. First time in our life, we were able to imagine. Their visual centers had opened up. This is what should happen. Every leader should have both the dimensions, visual and audio mode, should be highly developed. You know, this can happen through the yoga dimension. So when we conduct the yoga programs, we ask them to do this. And I was conducting this program of the sacred meditation, the SMET program. At the end of the class, One of the boys come and said, "Sir, today something weird happened. When you went on saying relax your toes, ankle joints, calf muscles and abdominal muscles, thoracic muscles, and you came to the head, relax your face, then suddenly I became very angry, very upset. I don't know what happened. All my relaxation went away, sir." In another session, the lady comes. "Sir, I want to talk to you in person." She came this side. She said, "See, when you went on telling this raishti like this, when you came to the head, I become totally depressed. All my relaxation which I was getting went away, you know." Another person said, "When I came there, I just started like laughing. I went on laughing for no reason whatsoever." You know, what is happening? This is what I call the stress release. When you do yoga, the deep-rooted stresses which are there hidden within us will all start coming out. The dirt within us is going to come out. You know, you have a vessel full of dirt, you put the vim and clean it, all the dirt is going to come out. Yoga is a process of purification. When you do that, then there's going to be blossoming. Then I said, nothing wrong with that. You continue the practice and after that sometime it will be all right. And the person who had that laughing thing, you know, he took almost 15 days after that, he stopped laughing. He was able to do yoga nicely. The person who went depression, it took almost 1 month before he was able to do that. The other person who was getting angry, within 1 week, he got normal. After a few months, they called me to their house. I go to that house. Parents of that person, that young lad, who has become very angry. Parents said, "Sir, what a miracle you have done for my son. He used to be always so much of angry and so much of upset. And always itna ho raha tha. Now he has become so calm, so quiet, so nice." And his wife told, "Sometimes he used to beat me because of anger. But now he's so nice. Even if I provoke, he's not going to become angry. What a miracle it has happened." This is the transformation in leadership. The lady who used to get depressed, you know, her parents told me that she had gone into depression. She had gone to the psychiatrist, she started taking medicine. And when she started doing that continuous everyday practice of half an hour to 1 hour, she started improving. And the psychiatrist, you know, told that you don't need so much of this thing. And last 1 month, she never went into depression. She's doing fine. What she does? Slow deep breathing and relaxation. It worked wonders. Then the person who was doing that laughing, you know, it's called the laughing gap, nitrous oxide, you know, when it goes into the brain, it triggers off the laughing reflex. So that also went away. So all the hidden things are going to get cleansed in the process of yoga. I was conducting a program in New York. And that day, I was sitting with the nice young couple and the wife went inside. She wanted to prepare some coffee and others to his her husband and others. So after she went inside, suddenly she screamed so loudly. Itna josh se chillayi. Immediately her husband ran inside. I also went inside. She was holding like this, whatever. All white and she was trembling. I thought she must have got some shock. I was trying to see where is the loose contact. I said, no. Then what? Why you are becoming like this? Look there. What? There was a lizard, chipkali, you know, lizard phobia, bolte hai na. See, lizard is such a harmless creature. Why you are so much afraid of that? She could not take the word lizard, you know. So, after some time when everything was over, I talked to her. I asked, "Do you see any particular incident from which you had this problem?" She said, yes, I clearly know when it started. When I was a young girl, only about 6 years old, and I started going to school. And that day I came back from school, and 2 o'clock, my mom nicely fed me, had a nice meal, a nice sleep I had. Since I was still very small, very young, and I used to still sleep in a big cradle. And when I woke up, you know, I started looking, then a lizard was coming here. Machardani hota hai na, mosquito net. Usse dhere dhere aa raha tha. Then I went on looking at it. Children become very curious. They go on looking. It's coming down. No, she was very nice. Suddenly it lost its balance. And okay, that was a trauma. From that day, she had this lizard phobia. She is now 52 years old. How long they carried from 6 to this? 46 years she carried this phobia. Did you not do anything? I did everything, sir. I did hypnotism, mesmerism, psychiatry, took medicine, nothing worked. What to do? I only have decided I will not bring the lizard into my room. Today it came. You know? Then I said, would you like to overcome this? Yoga is the best answer. Wonderful, I will do anything for that. I will come. She started coming for the yoga class. And deep relaxation. She started enjoying that IRT, QRT, DRT, the entire yoga practice and relaxation. And then I asked, imagine the vast, infinite blue sky. And slowly imagine a lizard, I told. She jumped up. Lizard. I said, relax. Lizard is a harmless creature. Nothing to worry about it. Do this, you know. And she was able to relax. Within 4 days, she was able to take the word lizard without a trauma. A big success for her. You know? Then, after the yoga practice, she would sit there and nicely meditate. It was the seventh day. And when she was sitting there nicely and enjoying the deep relaxation and calming of the mind, blissful awareness, then her husband has gone and brought a rubber lizard. Bachche khilone khelte hai na, wo lizard ka, chipkali ka, usko laya tha. And he kept it in her hand. He said, what is this thing? Oh, lizard. Put her mouth. I said, relax. Lizard is a harmless creature. Again, she was able to relax. 5 more days, she was able to flee with the lizard, that rubber lizard. 1 month, she was able to touch a live lizard. Her phobia had gone. We had Abdul Kalam. The first launch was done. You know, and it was a big failure. All the journalists became very angry. They all started coming, pouncing on Abdul Kalam. And then Dr. Dhawan was the chairman of the entire space mission. He comes and, Abdul, be here, I want to talk to them. He comes and tells, what is the matter, my dear journalist, what is the problem? What problem? You are telling? You have spent so much of money, thousands of crores, and such a big failure, and you are telling what is the reason? Then he says, do you know, this is our only 4th launch. No country has had a successful launch first time, second time, third time. In America, it is the 8th trials before we got a successful launch. In Russia, it is 9th. In France, it is 7th. In Japan, they do it in 6th or 6th. Ours is 4th thing. And we don't know the secret. Nobody is going to tell you all the secrets. We have to find out what are the secrets which make you failure. Therefore, in this launch, we have learnt a lot. These are all the things that we have learned, and therefore, this is not a failure in a sense. Failures are stepstones for progress. And probably next time it may be functional. And therefore, it's an investment, it is not a waste. Oh, we never knew. They wrote all these things very positively. And the next year, the 5th launch was a big success. So everybody came to congratulate Dr. Dhawan. So what you said is right, and then we are very happy. And no, you talk to Abdul Kalam, he is the man who built up the whole thing. Look at and talk to them how he was able to solve all these problems. This is a leader. No. All positivities that come, your team people will get this. Any negative things, you should address. How can this happen? With an expanded awareness. And you are full of transparency and sacrifice and other dimensions. And this is what we see in the great leaders in BSF, in our army, in our Air Force and everywhere. Full of love for the country and building the team spirit. And I know many incidents of our Sharmaji and then all these people, how they have been able to sacrifice and giving the wonderful dimension. So what is needed? How does yoga contribute in the whole thing? To expand our awareness from our individual to the group, to the team, to the country and see that it grows to the highest level. This is what Rustamji had visualized in the beginning when he started this border security force. How we can protect this entire country with so much of love for the country. And we should work on these things. And that leadership dimension can be enhanced by the dimensions of yoga. So when you bring this yoga, which he is trying to bring to everyone in the society, the key point is relaxation at the body level. Slowing down of the breath at the breathing level, calming down at the mind level, and positive emotions at the emotional level, converting every opportunity to develop our positive emotions and removing all psychological conflicts. Yoga works holistically, works at the body level, prana level, mind level, emotional level, intellectual level, brings a total transformation of the whole personality. This is what yoga does. For that we have asana, pranayama, meditation and all other dimensions. And this is what we have to bring in, and it can help not only for our growth and to convert and make people leaders, but I want most of you to become the great leaders. For that, spend some time to keep up your health, to develop yourself to greater and greater height. You know, many people said that we don't have time, we are so busy from morning to night, how we wish we had 30 hours a day, we don't have time. I gave the example of a prime minister. Every day, 1 hour. You know, how he spends? Are we more busy than our prime minister? How he works day and night? When he can spend 1 hour, why not we? Every one of us should take this resolve. But many ministers have been telling and they have started. Therefore, I want all the BSF team and the leaders and people should spend 1 hour for your practice. Spend time. If you invest 1 hour, you can reduce your sleeping hours by 2 hours, 3 hours. You know, it's an investment for you in time. And the wonderful leadership qualities will come and your health is going to improve. And particularly when you work in high altitude and other things, you have such things that happen that you are bound to get sick. Yoga can work wonders. You know? So if you are able to do this, it will be wonderful. Therefore, we have taken up this diabetes control program, cancer control program throughout the country, and we have been able to bring this yoga dimension to solve. Our Prime Minister said, you have to control this diabetes. India is becoming number one, challenging China that we will become the diabetic capital of the world. Should we not prevent? We did in 60 districts, 2.5 lakh people we screened and brought yoga, and wonderful results have come, and it has become a national program. Now we are taking up the cancer, oral cancer, breast cancer, and then cancer cervix, and 2 crores of people we are going to scan throughout the country, and we bring the yoga dimension. We had a lot of research before this. It's a scaling up program that we are doing. Therefore, I am requesting our DG and others that let us bring this wonderful thing. You are doing wonderful service among all the people in the border areas. And we can bring this dimension of screening and giving them the yoga practices and bring the dimensions of measurement. Show this is what we have done. You'll be very happy to join hands, and with that you'll be able to. One side, development of leadership, and the other side, offering this leadership talent to develop our society, particularly in the broader areas and the rural areas. It can be a great work of the BSF. They are building such wonderful work of financial dimensions. I was so thrilled to see your video, and they had done fantastic work. So add on this dimension for bringing yoga into the greater heights. Once again, I thank you very much and congratulate you for your fantastic, perfect organization. And thank you all your team. Dhanyavaad.
आदरणीय गुरु श्री ने अपने सरल सरस व ज्ञानपूर्ण उद्बोधन और बड़े ही प्राकृतिक रूप से बातचीत के जरिए बहुत सारी बातों को बताया, समझाया, और अब सभागार में उपस्थित आप सभी का प्रश्नोत्तर सत्र में स्वागत है.
समथिंग अबाउट द ड्रग एडिक्शन दैट परहैप्स इज नीडेड बिकॉज ऑफ द सोसाइटी पर्टिकुलरली यू नो is going all through gutka and other things, and our youngsters are getting addicted to that. So something on that, sir.
Drug addiction is one of the major problems in our country. Also it is spreading. Recently we had a big conference in Harvard University, role of yoga and Ayurveda in pain management of drug addiction. Then we went to the neighboring New Hampshire state, where 45% people have become opioid addiction and they have no solution. The government is spending millions of dollars opening up new rehabilitation center, no solution. They stay there for 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 5 months. When they get little better, they are brought back to the society, again they become addicts. So they were literally crying. The mayor came and the governor came, all this to the conference, and they were literally crying, what can we do? So it is here that yoga comes into picture. So by using yoga, we'll be able to develop the dimension to gain mastery over the mind. You know, addiction happens because of the repeated thinking of a thought, you get addicted to that. You know, And you must gain control over the mind to break that continuation thing. And that's what yoga does, gaining control. You should be able to calm down the mind. So we had done a lot of research in these dimensions and shown that you can use breathing as a very effective technique, and also the Kapalabhati has a cleansing technique to achieve this thing. So now we are written up a proposal to start this thing. Similarly, in Punjab also now we are taking up this addiction, yoga for addiction programs. We are trying to do these things. And it has a good hope, and we have to bring in yoga right from beginning. And also prevention is better. Therefore, prevention is better than cure, as we say. Therefore, right from beginning, if our children are taught to use the yoga, then they will get the control. Therefore, our Prime Minister was very keen that yoga should go into the education system. So we brought this yoga syllabus to NCTE, National Council of Teacher Educators. As you know, 13 lakh teacher educators get trained every year in our country. So yoga has been made compulsory. Then the NCERT came forward and we have formed the syllabus for the junior and the senior levels, and yoga is brought. At the higher education level, UGC asked us to prepare the syllabus at the higher education level that we have done. So if we can bring yoga into education system right from beginning, it will give a lot of inner strength and see that you don't succumb to the attractions of the sense pleasures of the drugs and others. So this is how we have to prevent one side and also deal with the things when you get drug addicted. Therefore, we are taking up a program for yoga for addiction in Punjab, here in our country, and United States. We are taking New Hampshire, and our top experts in this field have been joined together from NIMHANS and also from Harvard University. We are preparing a nice protocol for doing this thing, and hopefully in 1 or 2 or 3 years, we should be able to bring about substantially scientific evidence for the yoga for addiction in a scaled up manner.
I have a small question. It is said that the Supreme God, whatever it is available in the form of Supreme Being somewhere, and yoga being the art of connection, so it is mentioned perhaps in Gita also that we connect ourselves with that Supreme through meditation or yoga, and that's how we recharge, reinvigorate and revitalize ourselves. So at the end of the yoga, when we have got ourselves connected to the Supreme, so that's how we recharge ourselves and we feel energized. So is this interpretation right of meditation or yoga?
Yes, it's a process of expansion of awareness, which I was talking. So you expand your awareness to higher dimension, and the highest dimension is our pure consciousness, which you call as God. Infinite knowledge, infinite power, infinite freedom, infinite bliss. That's our original state, called as Swarupa by Patanjali. That's our original state. You may call it as God. Some people do not want to use the word God, because always God means they have their own small notion. But in scientific terminology, in our Shastras, it is our original state of pure consciousness. You know, what features that called as the Moksha or Nirvana by Patanjali and others is infinite knowledge, infinite power. So we are limited, we are going to expand towards that infinite thing. From Annamaya Kosha to Pranamaya, Manomaya, Vijnana, Anandamaya Kosha, and merge with the totality. That's the whole process of expansion. So by using yoga, you're going to tune and bring out all those into our day-to-day life. This is what Swami Vivekananda said. Yoga is a process by which you bring manifestation of the divinity in our day-to-day life. So you're right that we have to tune to that. That's the process of tuning, as we say.
On the aspect of the mind, can you enlighten us also on ways to reduce or prevent suicides today? We find a lot of suicides taking place, like drug addiction. There are a lot of cases of suicide. So any specific pranayams or any kind of specific yogic kriyas which you can suggest for the troops can adopt and have a reduction in the number of suicides which are taking place?
Unfortunately, in our education system, we have no component to deal with our emotions. Failure, success, you become highly excited. When you have failures, you get lost, commit even suicide. So this needs a training in our education system to deal with our emotion. That's what the science of emotion culture brings in the part of Bhakti Yoga. And we have included this thing in our education system. So in the program that we have brought out in the yoga dimension, we have to deal this thing. Just like we have a missing thing about calming up the mind, similarly dealing with emotions have been removed. As a result, people all over have been suffering from depression, suicide, as you rightly say. We were in Australia, in Melbourne. It was about 15 years back. It was the biggest problem is depression among the teenagers. When they should be bubbling with joy, enthusiasm, energy, vitality, they all have become gombies. It was a big concern for the federal government of Australia, and therefore they started a new project called Beyond Blue. And the Prime Minister had come in the Melbourne. They developed a huge building for this project. They initially gave $100 million for this project. They brought the best of the psychiatrists from Sydney University, made them the director, and told, now in the next 10 years, it should come down from 35 to 2 or 3%, if not 0%. If you want more money, we'll give you. Don't worry. And you must do everything possible to mitigate this. And last year I was there, I met the director and asked, now it is 13 years, sir, how is the situation? 35 is not reduced, hardly 36%. You know, why? The secret of gaining mastery over the emotions is not taught in the modern medical system. You only give medicines and other things. This is where yoga hits at the root cause. I was giving the example of emotional purification by using this dimension. When you do yoga, there's going to be a purification that starts from within. And that brings about the change. Unless you do this thing, you cannot have this thing. Therefore, our Prime Minister rightly has been emphasizing, yes, yoga should come to every person. Therefore, you should start developing dimension, then the problem will be solved. In most of our universities, others also, we are now introducing yoga so that it can handle the emotional distress, the suicide and addictions and all these things can be handled effectively.
Guruji, one very basic question I want to know. This is regarding breathing in, especially deep breathing in. Say, how you do it exactly? Do you expand your chest or it is bloating of the stomach? This is very basic, which is a lot of contradictory answers keep coming from the senior gurus also. So kindly clarify on this.
In breathing, normally you expand the chest and abdomen goes inwards. Not this thing. Initially when you lie down, for example, when you are breathing in, normally you expand the chest and contract. This is called the thoracic breathing. But what should happen to the abdomen when you are lying down and doing that? Inhale, abdomen comes up. When you exhale, abdomen should go down. Then abdomen goes up, there is going to be the things will become like this, and then you are going to expand dimension. So this is the connection between dimension, so that when you breathe in, abdomen should come forward, breathe out, abdomen should go inwards. This is the right technique for doing the abdominal breathing, and do that. If you are doing only thoracic breathing, don't worry about what happens to abdomen, do that. Expand and contract, expand and contract. But when you do the abdominal breathing, breathe in, abdomen should come forward, breathe out, abdomen should go inwards. That's the right thing. And in the full yogic breathing, we have got all the three things done. When you breathe in, abdomen will come forward, chest will expand, and clavicle breathing will go up there. And when you breathe out, this will come down, chest will contract, and abdomen will go down. All the three things happen in full yogic breathing.
Shraddhe Guruji, अध्यक्ष बाबा श्रीमती रेणु शर्मा, सीमा सुरक्षा बल के महानिदेशक श्री के शर्मा, सीमा सुरक्षा बल सहित केंद्रीय पुलिस बलों के अधिकारीगण, सभागार में उपस्थित विशिष्ट अतिथिगण, मीडिया प्रतिनिधि, देवियों और सज्जन, योग के माध्यम से लोगों को आरोग्यता प्रदान करने के लिए जगत विख्यात गुरु जी का विशेष आभार। आपने हमारा निमंत्रण स्वीकारा और योग तथा नेतृत्व विषय पर अपने बहुमूल्य विचारों से हमें अवगत कराया। आपके व्याख्यान को हम सब ने हृदयंगम किया है और हमें विश्वास है कि आपके द्वारा बताई राहों पर चलकर हमारी नेतृत्व क्षमता और प्रखर होगी। हमें मार्गदर्शित कर हमारी राहों को सुगम बनाने के लिए कोटि-कोटि धन्यवाद। आयोजक टीम को विशेष धन्यवाद। उत्कृष्ट प्रबंधन के माध्यम से आपने अपने दायित्वों का भली भांति पूरा किया है, जिससे सीमा सुरक्षा बल की कार्य कुशलता में वृद्धि हुई है। आपकी कुशलता के बने रहने की कामना है। मैं धन्यवाद करना चाहूंगा विज्ञान भवन के सभी अधिकारी कर्मचारियों का, दिल्ली पुलिस के अधिकारी कर्मचारियों का, जिन्होंने यह व्यवस्था बनाने में हमारी मदद की है। अंत में इस कार्यक्रम से जुड़े सभी लोगों और संस्थाओं का कोटि-कोटि धन्यवाद। आपके सहयोग से ही हम अपने लक्ष्य को पा सके हैं। धन्यवाद। जय हिंद।